All right, here it is. Match number four. You know what they say, fourth time is the charm. That's what I'm going to tell myself at least, so I don't feel so bad about getting completely crushed. Here we go. Turn one, Mimic. Let's do this. Turn one, Delver? Oh, Aether Vial. I wonder how the Merfolk matchup is. Eldrazi. Let's play the Displacer. Get in for three. I mean, this getting spreading seized is kind of annoying. Next turn we can play a 4/4 endless one. Or we can draw Eye of Ugin and play Eldrazi Mimic and a 5/5 endless one. Thoughts? Or we can get Spreading Seized and not play anything. Thoughts? Right, we'll play that. And guess I'm playing another Eldrazi Displacer. And get in there for six. Think that's better. It allows me to attack. Yeah, because our opponent could have put in a Curse Catcher. If I just play an Eldrazi Mimic and attack with both, I think that's a little bit worse. I do have the option to keeping up Dismember, but I do want to use Dismember to kill one of the Merfolk Lords. This is a matchup where Drowner is likely not great, just because it's going to be harder to get to six lands. Just already trying to figure out how I want to sideboard in this matchup. Don't really think it's a Warship. I mean, our opponent doesn't have any ways to deal with Warship, but. All right, there's the Dismember. So our opponent is at seven life. That's good for us. Ooh, that also isn't bad. So I do have the option of keeping up two removal spells, which I think I'm going to do. So what I think I'm going to do this turn is just attack with the Displacer. See what my opponent opts to do. Because this way, if our opponent puts in a Lord, it's okay. So our opponent's just going to chomp, which I'm okay with. So our opponent's going to put in a Lord here, which is also okay. Now I'm going to opt to. I don't want to give my opponent a land, so I guess I'll go with the Dismember here. Yeah, let's go with Dismember. Opponent's certainly not going to use up Curse Catcher there. Alright, now we get to play an extra Eldrazi Mimic. And the next turn, if we just draw land, we can just play an endless one and attack for loads of damage. I wonder if you board in Warship in this matchup. I just have no idea. Got my Caves of Koilos. All right. Now I can no longer cast my Path to Exile. So perhaps I should have cast that one. Never mind. Oh wait, no. I should have still cast it. ooh. Anyways, just going to play a 4-4 here. That represents lethal in a lot of different ways, and our opponent is likely just dead. Yeah. Okay, so looks like our main deck configuration is already pretty good against the Merfolk deck. I don't think Gutshot's particularly good. It kills like a few of the creatures, but it's the creature that you really don't care about. The creatures you want to kill are, of course, the Lords, which Dismember and Path to Exile deal with pretty handily. I don't really care about Stubborn Denial. Stony Silence is okay against the Vials, but I don't think like you want to bring it in if that's the only card in the matchup. So, honestly, the question is, do we want Worship in this matchup? I feel like, yeah, I mean, what type of cards are they going to be bringing in? I mean, they're going to be bringing in, I don't see them bringing in like Echoing Truth or something. So it could be good. What are we cutting for it though? See, the cards like Worship, it's like a trap. You see it and you're like, oh man, this card can be great. What do I cut? Like, will they have cards like? I'm just trying to figure out what cards Merfolk can have to deal with Worship. And I can't think of too many, so I can try it. Try it and see. The question is, what am I taking out? I think mimics are actually good because you can actually do a pretty good job of erasing them. Maybe we just cut a couple of endless ones. Displacer seems pretty nice. We have some nice synergies, so. Just ask Brandon Nelson. He says he takes these out pretty often. So I'll take out the endless ones and keep the Drowner of Hopes. I'm not sure which one's better. I mean, with the Mana Denial, it's possible, but the Drowner plus Eldrazi combo is pretty nice. Especially if we get to like a huge board stall, which involves Worship. So here, we've finally drawn multiple Eldrazi temples, but we have five lands and just two spells. We are on the draw. We do have a lot of large Eldrazi in our deck. Yeah, I'm gonna keep this. Let's see what happens. I got my two temples. We have two turns to draw a large threat. And having a yeah. There's a large threat. We even boarded some of those out. Although I guess we can just get Spreading Seas this turn. Yep. Silvergill Adept. Revealing Silvergill Adept. All right. Well, we drew two spells in a row. It's pretty lucky. Would love to draw a giant Eldrazi creature, but even if we don't, I mean, we have a 4-4 endless one to go with a Path and a Dismember. It's not terrible. Now, if our opponent does have a Dismember here, then we're going to be in some trouble. Incoming Silvergill Adept. I mean, that makes sense if you want to find a Spreading Seas or even land. And there is Regis. So no Dismember, most likely. Oh my goodness. Eldrazi. The luckiest Cheon in all the land. I'm wondering if I should be attacking with the endless one here. I probably should. Because, yeah, our opponent could also triple block here. But our opponent can double block endless one. And then take a bunch of damage. Hopefully, our opponent doesn't have a card like Dismember. Yeah, I mean, with the Lords too, you want to keep the Merfolk off the table. All right, there's a Vapor Snag. I imagine two creatures on the Endless One. Could also put three creatures on a Reality Smasher if a 5/5 Trampler is more problematic. Could also take nine, but I don't think that's going to happen. But yeah. Those are some pretty amazing draws, drawing the Endless One and the Reality Smasher. It's okay, we're just going to draw another Reality Smasher next turn, and then it's just going to be game. What they need to print now are colorless hosers. If they want Eldrazi to still be a deck, but not oppressive. You gotta come up with some colorless hosers. I'm surprised that there aren't more. Is our opponent just trying to kill us? Let's see, 2, 4, 6. You put in Reejuri and then the other Lord. That's 19 damage. Yeah. So what our opponent can do is play a Lord of Atlantis, target Mutavault, activate Mutavault, untap Mutavault, and that'll be 4, 8, 12, 16, oh no, that'll be 16 damage. That would be 16 damage. That is very close to lethal. Wow. All right, so here comes a Silvergill Adept, and that's a Curse Catcher. Okay. So a lot of Silvergill Adepts. Oh, that's a land. So now if our opponent plays another Lord and untaps Mutavault, no, that still doesn't do it. But we are going to take a ton of damage. We actually just need to draw Reality Smasher, I think. So our opponent has a Curse Catcher. Once again, our opponent plays Curse Catcher, untaps Mutavault, and attacks. So there is the Lord of Atlantis untapping a board. Oh, wow. Yeah, that is lethal. That's crazy. Right? 4, 8, 12, 13. No. I keep miscounting. Our opponent needs to play two Lords. Because this is only 16 damage. So our opponent can play a Curse Catcher here, untap Mutavault, attack for 16. With three blockers, and I can't cast my Dismember. In which case, Reality Smasher might be the only out. Oh, wow. It's another Lord? Oh my goodness. Okay, well, that's 15 damage, I guess. We still can't cast Dismember, which is unfortunate. Oh my god! I forgot about that card. Oh, you know, I just realized though. I just realized that worship is not the end all be all. Vapor Snag is loss of life. Vapor Snag is loss of life. Huh. All right. But that was the only card that would get us out of this. So that's pretty awesome. So we have no blue cards and this taps for blue mana, so yeah. Let's worship. But our opponent's board is humongous. We need to draw an Urborg to actually cast any of our dismembers. I need to, like, draw enough removal spells to get through all these Lord of Atlantises. I mean, Eldrazi Displacer will also help, because, you know, if we draw Eldrazi Displacer into Skyspawn or anything like that, Skyspawner would also be good, just because it's an evasive creature. That Worship was a pretty great draw, though. Now, at this point, our opponent just wants to, like, attack to get us to one, and we're going to let that happen. And just pray that we don't die to Vapor Snag. That's basically our out. I don't even think we block, because we can just get blown out by Dismember. Yeah, so this is just going to attack. If our opponent had Vapor Snag, obviously you just attack with everything. Yeah. Oh my god. Alright, fair enough. Okay, let's take out the Warships, I guess, and just bring in the Endless Ones and just... I don't think we sideboard. We just try to be as aggressive as possible. Man, that was a beating. Just right away. Not even making it dramatic. Like, you should wait like a few turns. I come back. I claw back. Get in the situation where I have Displaced with all these tokens. And then bam, I get bam. Oh, I had Vapor Snag the whole time. Sorry, Paul. I have a good feeling. We even drew the best possible. Ugh. Ugh. Every single turn, I think I like Vampiric Tutored, and I still lost. Alright. We have an Eldrazi Temple, Endless One. Yeah, I'll keep. Let's be aggressive here. Turn one, Isamaru. Ooh. Four. Now we just want to draw Eldrazi. The thing is, my opponent just needs to use removal spell. Like, Spreading Seas at this point is pretty bad. But a Vapor Snag or a Dismember would be quite strong. I guess Ghost Court, that's pretty sick too. Ghost Courting one of my lands and then also casting Dismember is also good. All right, that's an Eye of Ugin. Let's just play this. I don't think our opponent's going to be able to deal with both of our white sources, so I think I'm just going to go ahead and get a blue-white land. There's a Silvergill Adept. Come on, Eldrazi. I need an Eldrazi. Give me that Eldrazi. Master of the Pearl Trident. Okay. Let's get a blue-white. Or an Eldrazi Temple. That's not good. Kind of wanted to use the Urborg as a surprise when I had like Dismember. But yeah, our drawing, I guess, three lands in a row, not great there. I think we had a pretty, you know, decent opening hand. I could have waited on the Endless One, but I thought, you know, just curving out and playing my Endless Ones and then just trying to draw the Drazi was a better way to go about this game, especially because you have 28 creatures in your deck. You just have a really, really good chance of drawing a creature and, you know, by turn of three, which is all we needed. We just wanted another Eldrazi. Now we have a ton of mana. I don't know if their opponent has Stubborn Denial, but I'm just going to play Path to Exile now. On the Rejury. Like, the Rejury can get out of hand. It allows our opponent to just, like, play multiple spells in one turn. Dispel, interesting. Alright, we need something big here. Sky Spawner. Oh my goodness, I just realized my folly. This is a really bad set that I'm playing right now. A really, really bad set. Obviously, I should not be getting an island. Obviously, I should not be getting an island. Looks like our opponent's just going to take it here. Against the deck with Island Walkers. That was not a good play. Yeah, I mean, that was just a rookie mistake. It's just like the type of mistake that you make when you're... I mean, there's just no excuse. That was just really bad magic. Like, even if they didn't have Island Walk, let me think. Like, our opponent's going to tap something here. We'd have to chump. Yeah, but as is, we're just dead on board. But if not, our opponent could have attacked, and we'd go down to three life. Or I guess our opponent wouldn't have attacked with everything. But, wow. And then we would have drawn Caves of Koilos. All right, so we would have lost. But that still doesn't excuse getting the island there. But all right, let's see if we can pull it off. The legendary 05.